Hi everyone, and welcome back to Ho Tanta Passione. You remember the song Eye of the Tiger? Tan, tananan. Well, today Rafael Nadal was like Rocky Balboa facing Ivan Drago, and he got his sweet revenge. He just, 10 minutes ago, the match ended after 2 hours of battle. Well, Rafael Nadal showed to the entire world why he's called the King of Clay. You can beat Rafa 3 consecutive times in different tournaments, but it's almost impossible to defeat him twice within a week on clay. I'm saying impossible because only Novak Djokovic in 2011 managed to do that when he defeated Rafa in the final in Madrid and the final in Rome. But we all remember that was Novak Djokovic on his top ever. And I always keep saying that Roger, Rafa and Nole come from a different planet. So if you are asking me why did he win today? First of all, the completely different weather condition between Madrid and Rome. Madrid altitude, someone like Sasha Zverev could hit, his serve very, very fast. And also, he could basically open the court almost, with 1 or 2 shots. Instead, Rome has a weather condition much more similar to Monte Carlo and Roland Garros. But today, I think just... In a nutshell, Rafael Nadal won, first of all, for his very aggressive attitude from the beginning. He was in control of the rally. He was very deep, both with the forehand and backhand. And he was not basically moving back and changing his strategy. And if you consider in just 18 minutes, he was leading 4-love. Oh, yes. And also something fun, already against Sinner, yesterday against Shapovalov, and today at Zverev, the opponent won the toss and basically they all decided to receive, probably because they know that Rafa is quite emotional during the first serving games. But today was not the case, even when in the 5th game Rafa got broken by Zverev. He was keeping cool, he was keeping focus, and I believe the main reason why he secured the opening set was also because the German left his first serve in the locker room, at least in the first set, and also he was producing an insane amount of unforced errors. They were showing during the first set the statistics in terms of winners. They were 5 winners each, but unforced errors only 6 for Rafa and 15 for the winner of Madrid last week. At the same time, in the 8th game, Rafa had basically a set point, but in that case, Zverev managed to save the game with a couple of good first ball in. And in the 9th game, he was basically full of everything. It was probably one of the longest games, this one, and as well the 10th in the second set, but we're gonna get there. And everything was happening. Rafa was 15-30 down. He saved basically a break point, but before that, he just fell by the net. I think they show, after during the replay, I think that the lines on the court, basically, they are nailed down. And I think it's quite slippery on that point. Everyone was worried. They were showing as well Mary, his wife. She was very, very concerned and like me, worried. They were showing, Rafa was all covered in clay. He had like a little cut, basically, on his left hand. But because he's a champion and because he was so focused, and I think he would never give up the first set or eventually to give an opportunity to Zverev to reopen the match, he sealed, basically, the opening set in 49 minutes. So after he went, you know, in the dressing room, of course he got changed, he got back in his fighting mood, and I have to say, once again, even if in the opening game of the second set, Zverev saved basically a break point on the score of 30-40, the two following games went very quickly, but in the fourth game of the second set, probably Zverev could have his turning point, but Rafa was good enough basically to push him back. He was a love 40 down, but he showed to the entire world that he has a very warm heart, but you know, a very cold mind, because he was doing the right thing at the right time. Master of tactics, he won 5 consecutive points, one better than another, and he sealed basically the score on 2-all. But immediately in the following game, in the fifth one, was another game of pure perfection. He was showing all the variety of his shots. At the same time, he was calling much more Zverev by the net. Is an area where, of course, the tall German player doesn't feel very comfortable. It was quite unique also to see Zverev to hit a smash by the net miles away. So at that point, Rafa got another break and he was leading with a score of 3-2. So in the following serving games, Rafa was quite struggling. Again, in the sixth game, he was 15-40 down, but with a beautiful forehand down the line and with the two amazing drop shots, he managed, you know, to get on deuce and secure that game as well. So Zverev seemed much more confident on serve. He was making some aces, and at that point, we were on the score of 5-4, so in the 10th game, Rafa went on serve, basically to secure his win and to try to enter the semi-final here in Rome, in the Eternal City, for the 12th time. But again, that was the super long, probably the longest game of the entire match. He saved 3 break points, the first with an unforced error of Zverev, that basically hit very, I think was a forehand that landed, you know, after hitting the net a few inches long, after Rafa did a very brave drop shot, and another very good, a classic serve of Rafa, kind of banana serve, that was returned just into the net by the German. And exactly when the clock was showing at 2 hours, he could celebrate, and he came by the net, you know, to win the last point, and he could basically raise his hands in the sky, and he could take all the warm excitement of the Roman crowd. I'm very pleased, I'm very happy. Of course, after the marathon of yesterday, at least it was a less stressful match today. Instead of 3 hours and 27 minutes, only 2 hours. But it's always a pure joy for me to see any kind of a match of Rafa, in particular on clay. Thank you so much also to all of you, almost 3,000 views for my video of yesterday. I really appreciate, and I'm glad at least, you know, a lot of you like that video. So at this point, Rafa had his sweet revenge, and tomorrow he's going to play his semi-final against the other giant American, Opelka, who defeated the Argentinian Delbonis with a score of 7-5, 7-6 in 1 hour and 41 minutes. Also, another thing that I forgot, I was quite pleased to see that Rafa was much more consistent today with his serve, and they were showing a statistics that I think it's very important. He was winning the 88% of the points with the second serve. So this is a key, and this is probably something that he needed to boost a lot of confidence, like he said yesterday during the press conference after the win. He said, "I'm managing not to survive in Barcelona against Tsitsipas, yesterday with Shapovalov, now against Zverev. So this is very good for my confidence. I realized that, you know, I can compete and play for such a long match, and I'm able, you know, to recover." I just would like to say to all of those people who were kind of saying, even commentators, "Oh yeah, but Zverev finished a few hours later than him yesterday in the three set match against the Nishikori." I just would like to remind all of you, Zverev is 24 years old, Rafa almost 35. Come on, are you kidding me? Someone who is 11 years younger than Rafa has more problems to recover. I don't know, just let's give a credit to a great champion. Today he was much better than last week. Probably he was playing on a much better court where he feels more comfortable. So that's all for today. I'm going to have some lunch and probably just to see a little bit of Djokovic versus Tsitsipas. Also, congratulations so much to Sonego, the Italian who yesterday defeated in another incredible match Dominic Thiem, and who's going to play this evening the other quarterfinal against Andrei Rublev. I'm pretty sure that Rafa tomorrow will play as a first semifinal. They haven't shown, you know, the schedule for tomorrow, but stay tuned. Early afternoon for sure, and stay tuned here on 80 Passione. Subscribe to this channel if you are in love with Rafa, but overall, if you love this incredible sport, the sport of the devil. That's all for today. Ciao!